If we look at emerging markets, there's a plethora of risks. Fed, China, trade wars. When you look at emerging markets, where is it that stands out for you that you want to have and continue to have your exposure?
I mean, we desperately want to buy emerging market stocks. In general, we are big fans of growth as a style, and emerging markets definitely offer you a lot of it. So there are lots of growth opportunities to be found in emerging markets. Emerging markets are also quite cheap, which is quite unusual to find cheap growth. Unfortunately, there are lots and lots of risks, and unfortunately the political situation and unfortunately the trade war kind of scaring investors from going there, worsening sentiment. So we're looking to go in there. We don't think it's there. I have to say, I've been trying very, very hard to persuade clients to kind of take a leap of faith. I think we're people genuinely waiting to kind of see some normalization, some stabilization. It is our central case that global economy is not going to collapse, is not going to go in recession, and emerging markets offer you a lot of opportunity to capitalize on that. But
If I was sitting in front of you, I would be convinced on the merits. I'll tell you why, because you sent me a chart, and it's based on, well, it's based on fact. Yeah. I mean, you say, yeah, you're dying to buy them. And I just want to talk me through the valuations, which is in the chart, which is the PE, the price equity basis of EM relative to developed markets. And this is what we put together that you sent through to me. Yeah. It's a heck of a differential, isn't it?
Hold on, let me see. So how do you read the charts?
So at the top line, you've got the blue, you've got the world, the world PE, and then we've got the MSCI PE for EM. So it's 13 to 18 with my yellow line at the bottom, which is my differential, which is narrowing a little bit. But if we look at that gap, there's still that overarching, I suppose, baseline financial theme.
Absolutely. So emerging markets are not expensive, but they're probably derated, discounted for a reason. And the reason is trade war, and the reason is potential effects of the slowdown. So we do need to get through this kind of negative sentiment loop. And I suspect there is a bit too much discount there that probably can come out, but we do need to see stabilization in a kind of economic backdrop. Once that's done, once that's behind us, we probably see some very, very strong appreciation. I don't think we're there yet, but it's probably coming sooner rather than later. So we're very careful on that one. So that's definitely something very, very top of our kind of watch list. So we're there, we're watching, but you do need to see some stabilization in kind of overall sentiment.